And that's the culture that we have today. We have a culture of the women running around the streets being adulterous whores. And you have a culture of teaching men that it's cool to take another man's woman. Upstairs, pack your bags. While you at it, call a cab. It's obvious you're playing around. Go upstairs and get your out of here now.
You're brave. Mm-hmm. Take your sneakers off.
Take my sneakers off?
Yeah.
Want me to leave right here?
Yeah, coffee.
Yeah, where you been at?
We miss you.
Yeah.
All
right.
This is the book of Sirach 26 and 7. An evil wife is a yoke shaken to and fro. He that hath hold of her as though he held a scorpion. Verse 11. Watch over an impudent eye, and marvel not if she trespass against thee. She will open her mouth as a thirsty traveler, when he hath found a fountain, and drink of every water near her. By every hedge will she sit down and open her quiver against every arrow. Shalom, it's the brother Azana Moth back at you with another lesson. I pray this lesson is edifying to the body, the lambs of Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai Bahashem, Rahakwadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, who do be well. And peace and salutations to all you Akim. Now, BBD, they warned us back in the 90s, all right? Never trust a big butt and a smile. Why? Because that girl is poison. And us men, we understand we're in Sodom, all right? Everything is destroyed here. Everything is disgusting here, all right? Just like the act that we just saw, all right? There's no morals instilled in a lot of you women, okay? And it's become a disease, more like an epidemic. Here it is, all right? The man of the house is out doing some type of work, dealing with all types of hell, okay, with Esau sometimes, working two jobs sometimes to hold down the fort, all right? Supporting you in all your necessities, okay? And here it is, Eve got some other man, all right, in her husband's house. He even came out the man's house afterwards, eating on cookies and chips. So whoever this woman is, she ain't worth two dead flies. Okay, and there's millions of men that are basically unhappy, but they suck it up just to keep you satisfied. All right, accommodating all your wants and needs. And this is how you repay your husband. All right, shaking your ass in the hallway, smacking your ass, and another man goes in there and sleeps with you. This is adultery. The Most High is against this. You can't even get sick without the help of your husband, because you ain't got no medical insurance. And this happens every day in our communities. You know, of the husband putting his wife to death for her committing adultery. That's actually biblical for a man to put his wife to death. You worthy of death. And that's what you women aren't considering. When you're in your flesh, you're not counting the cost on how you might end up on the curb just like this woman. You're not thinking about the wrath of your husband, okay? When he catches you in that situation, or better yet, the Most High, when he puts the spirit on your husband, all right, to come down on you. You see, this is not a game. Many men have taken L's and are lying in graves because they believe in a woman okay, and that she was single. Many men have lost their wits, okay, for falling after a woman who was married because she lied to him, leading him astray. And now that man's laying in the grave, all right, then called a body. A lot of women flirt at your jobs. You got work husbands. All right, these things are going on, and it leads to what we just saw in the hallway. All right, adultery. We can draw up many scenarios from the deeds of promiscuous women, all right, and devious harlots proclaiming to be wives. This is the book of Sirach 26 and 22. And harlot shall be accounted as spittle, but a married woman is a tower against death to her husband. Yeah, a harlot shall be accounted as spittle. Let me just say this to the women in the truth that know how you're supposed to move and conduct yourself as a wife of a prophet. Not saying no one is, because I prayed all the real Aqua find salvation as well. All right, but if you lose patience and you're enticed, the Lord just may pull your cord, okay? And it's flatline. You see, because the Lord put the spirit on your husband to put you down. This is Sirach 25 and 25. Give the water no passage, neither a wicked woman liberty to gad abroad. Yeah, you don't let your woman gad abroad, being a busybody, all up in everybody else's business. You see, don't know how to take care of the home. And now she in the hallway shaking her ass for other men. This is Sirach 25 and 26. If she go not as thou wouldest have her, cut her off from thy flesh and give her a bill of divorce and let her go. Yeah, you have to let her go. The best thing for a man to do, all right, is give her a bill of divorce. Just like with her brother text her, all right, get out of my house right now. And sometimes the Lord won't even allow that divorce to facilitate. See, he may send judgment immediately because he might put the spirit on your husband to put it down on you, right? Call the coroner. If you have a man of the Lord, you got to cherish him like a rare gemstone. Okay, because by his works and his faith, he may have, okay, a first-class ticket out of Babylon, which means that the Lord may have mercy and grace on you as well, all right, and your children. Or you can continue to be in your flesh, being just like Jezebel, who died a terrible death torn apart by ravenous dogs for her manipulation and seduction of the prophets. She misled the saints into the sins of idolatry and sexual immorality. And the women today are in that same mindset. Jezebels, right? That woman that we just saw in the clip, hey, there's millions that have that spirit, right? Brother doing his best to take care of you, and you're out being a damn slut. And if you don't have the right spirit, all right, to give that woman a bill of divorce, all right, for adultery, hey, the Lord just might put your wife away himself. You see that? Like he did Ezekiel's wife. The Lord will take the desire of your eyes. This is Ezekiel 24 and 15. Also the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Son of man, behold, I take away from thee the desire of thine eyes with a stroke. Yet neither shall thou mourn nor weep, neither shall the tears run down. The Lord said, don't even weep or cry for that woman, because you thought that she was the desire of your eyes and your heart, right? But Yahweh's eyes are 10,000 times brighter than the sun, all right? So when a woman believes that her actions can be justified by being an adulterer, the Lord just may take her out with a stroke. All right, just like he did Ezekiel's wife. All right, just like it reads in the book of Psalms, pray not for these people. The Lord commanded Ezekiel not to drop a tear from his wife. Ezekiel 24 and 18. So I spake unto the people in the morning, and at even my wife died. So the Lord put her to death. All right, the desire of his eyes. So if you women really believe in the scriptures, you would take heed to Proverbs 31 and 10 on down. Because as a wife, you should submit yourself to your husband, not being an adulteress. Let's get that in Ephesians. This is Ephesians 5 and 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your husbands as unto the Lord. When you submit yourself to the Lord, that will lead you to the understanding of submitting yourself to your husband. All right? The order that was set up. Submitting yourselves to your husbands, not shaking your ass in front of other men, okay? But to honor him. You are to honor your husband. If you women had the mindset, all right, let's say of a Esther, what is she saying in the first chapter of that book? Hold up, let me get it, hold on. Because Esther, she made a proclamation, okay? Hey, honor your husband. This is Esther 1 and 20. And when the king's decree, which he shall make, shall be published throughout all his empire, for it is great, all the wives shall give to their husbands honor, both the great and small. You see this right here? No Israelite man should have to live like this, where you have to peek over your shoulder to see if your woman is manipulating you, right? You really don't have enough evidence, but you think she's doing something. You shouldn't live like that, right? But Babylon has trained these women to be seductive, to be liars, to be deceptive, right? And we're seeing it on all levels. So Esther said to honor your husband, all right, great or small. Not dishonor your husband, right? That woman was dishonorable. And the Lord is going to put all these women to death pretty soon, man. Okay? By the violence of the enemy, the oppressor is going to put them to death. Jacob's trouble, they're going to be put to death. All right? When 2 Ezra 15 and 16 open up, they're not going to have a hedge of protection. So honor your husband, all right, so you can be in favor. This is Sirach 26, 26. A woman that honoreth her husband shall be judged wise of all, but she that dishonoreth him in her pride shall be counted ungodly of all. Yeah, you're counted ungodly, right? Looked at as a wench, a harlot, a whore. Just like the man said, get out of my house. And you're going to find yourself in situations of peril, right? Just through the spirit, I said to myself, hey man, this is happening every day. Every day where men are out, you know, busting their ass, you see? And you at home got a free pass. Well, them days are up. We're going to see more of this. Get your shit and get out. I pray this lesson has been edifying to the body and elect of Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim Rahak Wadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone who do it well. Peace and salutations to brothers on the moth. On to the next. Shalom.